Computers, like dads, aren't exactly known for their sense of humor. Lost in a sea of zeros and ones are a number of factors that make jokes funny and make us humans. When scientists first began grappling with machine humor, the challenges they had were mostly linguistic in nature. Could a machine detect and emulate a jokester's intonation, their syntax, the puns that fuel their one-liners? But even as scientists have made great strides in natural language processing, computers haven't gotten very far beyond a string that appends, "That's what she said," to the end of a sentence. At first, computers might seem decently poised to deliver quips that pack a comedic punch. Comedians rely heavily on formulas, after all. Your average sitcom writer makes use of stock characters and story arcs. But it turns out formulas aren't quite the same thing as algorithms. Why not? The answer might very well be whether or not the comedian and audience have a shared cultural context. Joel Morris, a British comedy writer, thinks of this cultural bonding as very tribal, and a way of saying, "I'm like you." Consider these two nonsensical jokes. There's nothing inherently funny about them. Now, the first one, written by a child, can easily elicit laughter, even though it's little more than an assemblage of nouns and adjectives. But consider this computer-generated joke. A lot of the same ingredients there, but the delivery on the second joke feels, well, robotic. That's because the first joke perfectly encapsulates a child's head-scratching sense of humor, a childlike sense of wonder and unfettered creativity. But it's even more likely that this difference simply comes down to the subjective nature of comedy. No joke will land 100% of the time on 100% of audiences. And the fact that we don't identify with automated comedians lowers those odds dramatically. The reason why we enjoy Siri or Alexa's canned jokes as much as we do is because these jokes are rooted in specific contexts, conceived and encoded by human programmers. No one knows whether we'll ultimately have to expand our definition of humanity, endowing computers with sentience and creative thinking. But as long as robotic jokesters fail the Turing test, they won't make us laugh. Mostly because we won't let them.